Several homes in Goldsby are safe and sound tonight, all thanks to the work of 15 fire departments. Friday's fires spanned nearly 4 miles and cost hundreds of thousands of dollars worth of damage. But if not for the heroic work of so many firefighters, it could have been much worse. Eyewitness News5's Carla Wade is live with one man's incredible story. Carla.
That's right, Paul. In Goldsby, there was not a lot of damage to homes like this one. Most of the structures that were burned there were not homes at all, but people did lose a lot of farm equipment in that very rural area. One of those people was an 85-year-old man we spoke to today.
And the fire went around the house and came back and swapped up in here. The wind whipped it back in here and caught this evergreens on fire, and that was where lost the house.
The house he's lived in since 1978 is still standing, but hundreds of acres of Gene McPherson's property are blackened and in some places still smoldering. McPherson lost 1,000 bales of hay, and numerous pieces of farm equipment were either damaged or destroyed. Nothing but heaps of melted, mangled metal today. It's estimated about 14 square miles of rural farmland in Goldsby was seared by one of three grass fires that blazed across McLean County. At 85 years old, McPherson says it was the first time he had to battle the forces of nature to save his home, even though firefighters tried to stop him.
They wanted me to leave. They had a first aid unit out here. They put me in it two or three times and put oxygen on.
But he says he'd do it again, and he appreciates everything everyone did to help.
I've never seen anything like this. I just never did.
And McPherson says that he's feeling much better today, though it took him a long time to get that smoke out of his lungs and in his nostrils. He says now he's just trying to figure out how he's going to clean up his property. Reporting live, Carla Wade, Eyewitness News 5.
Carla, quite a story. You know, most of the structures burned in Goldsby were just barns.